we have determined that there is reasonable cause to believe that the Albuquerque Police Department engages in a pattern or practice of use of excessive force.
Today, the Department of Justice released its report after a 16-month-long investigation into APD. It was in response to a series of deadly police shootings from 2009 to 2012. The investigation found that some APD officers too frequently used deadly force when there was no imminent threat. They used tasers on people who posed only a minimal threat. Also, the use of excessive force by officers is not isolated or sporadic. And there has been a failure to implement an object and rigorous internal accountability system. Now, a significant amount of the cases as well involve persons who were mentally ill. The DOJ says many of those cases violate the Fourth Amendment. Target 7 investigative reporter Nancy Laughlin begins our team coverage to explain what that means.
Well, Doug, it was the family members of the people who had been involved in APD shootings and some community groups who asked for the Department of Justice to come to Albuquerque. Today, the DOJ made it clear this was not a criminal investigation. This one involved civil rights. We spoke one-on-one with the Department of Justice attorney.
In the past month, there have been protests against
no justice, no peace,
and rallies for the Albuquerque Police Department.
APD.
A boiling point in the community. The Department of Justice announcing today it hopes suggested changes in policing will mean a more peaceful police force.
It is a false choice to say that you need to use force in order to keep a city safe.
A year and a half ago, the Department of Justice began investigating APD, going on ride-alongs, holding community meetings, and reviewing reports. And before and during the investigation, 23 fatal shootings, 3 police chiefs, and millions of taxpayer dollars shelled out in civil suits because of those shootings. Some of them involve people with mental illness or who are in crisis. Other shootings, people with a very long, violent criminal history. But today the feds said they found APD has a pattern of excessive force.
A lot of officers have said this is a particularly violent city, and that's why they do what they do, that they want to go home to their families too.
What we have found is that constitutional policing is effective policing. When police engage in respect for constitutionally guaranteed civil rights, it makes their job easier to do, it engenders public trust, it helps them to promote public safety.
Now the DOJ wants to see major changes, including changes in use of force policies, training, recruiting, and how officers interact with people with mental illness.
I do think that the city has instituted some measures that I hope will bear fruit. They are a start, but they are not sufficient to create the kinds of structural reforms that are really necessary to ensure that the Albuquerque Police Department becomes an effective, accountable, constitutional police force.
Tonight I spoke with some officers who say the DOJ's findings just pushed morale into an all-time low. APD is already down at least 200 officers. Now some are saying they are looking to leave because they believe all of these changes will jeopardize their safety.
While the Department of Justice found there were too many officer-involved shootings in Albuquerque, we wanted to know if officers here were targeted more frequently as well. That report tonight at 10.